The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita, as it is, 13th chapter, text number 1 and 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 13th, 1975, in Durban, South Africa.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. We are reading one chapter from Bhagavad Gita, 13th chapter. The subject matter is nature, the enjoyer, and consciousness. In Sanskrit it is called Kshetra, Kshetragna. Kshetra means the field, just like an agriculturist, they work on the field. The worker or the agriculturist owns the land and he works there, and according to his labor, he enjoys the fruit. Similarly, we have been given this body as a field of activity. Every one of us, not only human beings, but also other living entities, there are 8,400,000 forms of living entities. Jalajanamalakhan. In the water, there are 900,000 forms of living entities. Then, Jalajanamalakhan is Sthavara Lakhavinshati. Sthavara means the living entities who cannot move, just like the tree, plant, grass, vegetable, they are standing in one place. They are also called having no legs. Ahastani sahastana. Abhadani chaduspadam. This is nature's law, that the living entities which have no hand, they are eatable for the living entities who have hands. Ahastani sahastana. Abhadani chaduspadam. And the living entities which cannot move, they are the food for the living entities which has got four legs. Nunam mahatana tatra jiva jivasya jivanam. In this way, the weak is the food for the strong. This is the law of nature, that one living entity is the food for another living. So, when a person eats another living entity, it is not unnatural. This is nature's law. But when you come to the human form of living entity, you must use your discrimination. Just like one living entity is food for the another living entity, it does not mean in the lower animals, sometimes the father, mother eat the offspring. But in the history of human society, it has not come into notice that the father, mother eating the offspring. But time has come when the mother is killing offspring. That has come already. This is due to Kali Yuga. So, here Arjuna's question is to understand the field and the worker on the field. He questions, Arjuna was, Arjuna inquired from Krishna, Prakriting Purushang Chaiva Chetrang Chetragam Mevacha Etat Deditam Ichyami Jnanam Jnayam Chakeshava. Krishna's another name is Keshava. So, he is addressing Krishna, my dear Keshava, I want to know these subject matters, Prakriti Purush. Prakriti means nature, material nature. And Purusha means the enjoyer, just like the living entity. We are trying to enjoy this material nature. Another Prakriti Purush. Purusha means, real Purusha means the supreme enjoyer, God, Krishna. And Prakriti means which is enjoyed. Another meaning, Prakriti means woman, and Purusha means man. So, this material world is going on. One party is trying to enjoy and the other party is being enjoyed. So Arjuna wanted to know what is the distinction, what is the integral part and parcel of this Prakriti and Purusha. Then, Kshetram Kshetravyam. Ga means one who knows, and Kshetraga, and one who knows the field. Just like the agriculturist, the cultivator, he knows that this is my field. He works there. Different cultivator works in his own field. So this Kshetra means this body. Kshetra, the field of activity. We have got different field of activity. So Kshetra, Kshetra Gancha, Kshetra Meva, Etat Veditum Ichyami. My dear Krishna, I want to know from you. Why he wants to know from Krishna? Because Krishna is infinite. Whatever knowledge we get from the infallible, that is perfect knowledge. Ordinary human beings, they are not perfect. Ordinary human beings are subjected to four deficiencies. We are ordinary human beings. We commit mistakes. That's a fact, every one of us. We are illusion. Our senses are imperfect. And with all this paraphernalia, when we want to teach, that is not teaching, that is cheating. Because I am imperfect, how can I be teacher? That is not possible. Therefore, we have to learn from a person who has no defects in his life, or a liberated person. A liberated person means he does not commit mistake, he is not illusion, he does not cheat, and his senses are not imperfect. This is the four signs of liberated person. So, our process, the Krishna consciousness movement means, we take knowledge from Krishna, who is liberated from these four kinds of deficiencies. That knowledge is perfect. Similarly, Arjuna is also inquiring from Krishna. Etat veditum icchyam. Etat vedit. Etat veditum icchyam jnanam jayam cha krishnam. What is actual knowledge and what is the subject matter of knowledge? That means six questions are presented by Arjuna before Krishna. One, where prakriti purush, chetra chetra jnana, and jnanam jnanam. What is knowledge and what is the subject matter of knowledge? Six questions. Sri Bhagavan was. Now here Krishna is speaking, but Vyasadeva, who recorded this dialogue between Krishna and Arjuna, he is writing Bhagavan Uvas. He does not say Krishna Uvas. Krishna may be misunderstood. But Krishna is Bhagavan. He wants to stress on this point. Krishnasu Bhagavan Svayam. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, it is stated by Vyasadeva that Krishnasu Bhagavan Svayam. Similarly, in the Brahma Samhita, it is stated Ishara Parama Krishna. Ishara means controller. So Parama means the supreme. So every one of us, we are more or less controller. But we are not supreme controller. We must know this. Ishara Parama Krishna. There are some men who claim to become Ishara, to become God. So we have no objection. That if somebody says, I am God or I am controller, we have no objection. But if somebody says that I am supreme God or supreme controller, then we have got it. Supreme means he has no control. And ordinary controller, just like we are, you are controller, you are controlling some sphere of life, I am also controlling some. But I also being controlled. But Ishara Parama Krishna means he is the supreme controller. He has no controller over you. He controls everyone, but he is not controlled by anyone. Therefore it is called Ishara Parama Krishna. Satchidananda Vigraha Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarva Karana Karanam. These are the Vedic statements, and our process of knowledge, Veda. Veda means knowledge. Vedic Veda is a Vyan. Supreme knowledge, perfect knowledge. That is Veda. So, Krishna is the supreme person. He is the speaker of Veda. The subject matter of Veda is to know Krishna. Vedaishta sarvai aham eva vedam. If you are a student of Veda, then you must have clear conception of God. That is real knowledge. No vague idea, but clear conception. That is knowledge, Vedic knowledge. Ultimate, therefore, the Vedanta philosophy. Veda means knowledge, and Anta means the ultimate. Everything has got ultimate. So So Vedanta means the ultimate knowledge of Vedas. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, you'll find in the 15th chapter. Vedaisya sarvai aham eva vedam. Vedanta vid, Vedanta kritya aham. So he is the compiler of Vedanta philosophy and he is the knower of Vedanta philosophy. Therefore, Arjuna is asking from Krishna because he is the ultimate and ultimate supreme person means Bhagavan. Bhava means opulence and Van means one who possesses. The word Sanskrit, but it is added when there is the question of possessing, pastate, but and bhat, pratyaya. This is Sanskrit grammar. So, bhagavat, bhava means opulence. Opulence means six times of opulence. Saresha japur, all wealth, all fame, all strength, all beauty, all knowledge, all renunciation. These are the opulences. We can have some money. You have some money, I have got some money. But none of us can claim that I have got all the money. That is not possible. That is claimed by Bhagavan. I have got some strength. You have got some strength. But nobody of us can claim that I have got all the strength. So one who possesses all the wealth, all the strength, all the fame, all beauty, all knowledge, all renunciation, he is called Bhagavan. The meaning of Bhagavan is this. Saraisajya Purna. Therefore, Vyasadeva says, Bhagavan Vasa. He is not ordinary person, he is speaking. Who is full with all knowledge. Because that is the qualification of Bhagavan. He is competent with all knowledge. So Bhagavan was. So what does Bhagavan say? Idam shariram kaunteya khetram iti abhidhiyat. My dear, kaunteya, Arjuna. Arjuna, another name is Kaunteya. Because he is the son of Kunti. His mother's name is Kunti. Therefore, he is addressed as Kunti. And Kunti has got relationship with Krishna. Kunti is the sister of Krishna's father, Vasudeva. Therefore, out of affection for his aunt, he is addressing Arjuna as the son of his aunt Kunti. Kaunteya. Idam shariram kaunteya kshetram. The field of activity, iti abhidhiyate. The two answers, out of the six questions, kshetra, kshetragna, prakriti, purush, jnan, jnana, is answering the first two pairs. What is kshetra? So Krishna says, this body is the khetra. Khetra means this body. And khetra-gra, khetra-gra vetti, this body, one who knows this body. Khetra-gra vetti, tanga-prahu khetra-gra, he is called khetra-gra. It's like, I know my body. The pains and pleasure of my body, the necessities of my body, how I am situated in this body, I know. You also know. You are about your body. About my body, you do not know. What pains and pleasure I am feeling, what pains and pleasure you are feeling, I do not know. But I know the pains and pleasure of my body. You know the pains and pleasure of your body. Therefore, in relationship with your body, you are Kshetrajna, and in relationship with my body, I am Kshetrajna. My body is Kshetra, the field of activity, and your body is the field of activity. So this is clear conception of Kshetra and Kshetrajna. The body is called Kshetra, and the knower of the body, if you simply study our body, if we simply take this question little seriously, whether I am this body or I am different from my body, to study each and every part of your body, to study your finger, you know, or I know, it is my finger. I do not say it is I finger, it is my finger. Therefore, I am different from my body. That's why I say it is, this is my issue. So I am not issue. But similarly, you study every part of your body, you know that it is your body. You are not this body. This is study. This is meditation. First of all, study your body. Whether you are body or you are different body. That is actually, the other day I was speaking, that a man's father has died and he is crying, my father has gone. So my father, your father is lying on the bed. The father which has been so long, lifelong, the body that is on the bed, why you are crying, your father is gone. That means he has never seen his father. Neither the father has seen the son. Everyone sees this body, but not the owner of the body. That is the defect of modern education. That everyone, by contemplation, can understand that this finger is my finger, not I finger. Still he cannot understand that he is different from his body. That is to be understood. That is real knowledge. Kshetra, Kshetrajnaya, Jnanam. One should have very clear knowledge that I am not this body. This is my body. You are not this body. It is your body. You are spirit. I am spirit. We are different from this body. This is the first instruction given in the Bhagavad Gita in the beginning. Dehinasmin yatha dehi kaumara yuvanam jara tatha dehantara prapti dhirasattva namayati. We are not this body. I am not this body. You are not this body. We are changing body every moment in perspective. Changing body. Sometimes it is found that the child has grown now to become a boy. But he has not become suddenly a boy. The body has changed. Body has changed every minute. But all of a sudden, or at a certain moment, we see that the body has changed. So, this is real knowledge. That I am not this body, I am changing my body, and when I shall finally change this body, I will get another body. This is my position. Tatha dehantara prapti. So, Krishna says, etajya vetti tanga prahu kshetrajna iti tad vidaha. If one understands that he is not this body, he is different from this body, from practical example and practical experience, one can understand it. Especially human being can understand it. And if the human being neglects this understanding, then he remains animal. So he will go for all. That is the injunction of the Shastra. Jashnata buddhi tunapi tithatati sadhik palatra disibhavama yujyati jaktitha buddhi salile natarhiti janesu avijyati saiva gopara jashnata buddhi tunapi tithatati. This body, according to Ayurvedic system of medicine, this body is made of three elements. Papa Pritta Bhava. Mucus, bile, and cough. So Tridhasuke, this body is made of material element. I am spirit soul. I am not material element. Aham Brahmasmi, I am spirit soul. This is knowledge. But if one does not take this knowledge, he remains with the bodily concept of five. I finger, not my finger, then he will ignore. I head, not my head. Nobody says I head, everyone says my head. And find out who is I. This is knowledge. Therefore, Krishna says, etadja vetti, one who understands this simple education in the beginning. Etadja vetti, if anyone understands this, that I am not this body, I am the owner of the body, I am the occupier of the body. The body is just like a rented house, and there are two interested persons. One is the occupier and the other is the owner. That is explained, that I am the occupier of this body. I am not actually owner. The owner is Krishna or God. This house is owned by Krishna or God. But just like the field, the agriculturist, the cultivator takes the land from the king or the government. He pays little tax and he works on it. Similarly, everything belongs to God. Isavasamidam sadvam. Nothing belongs to us. We also belong to God. This is knowledge. But God has given this piece of farm or land for our activity. That is explained in the next verse. Krishna says, Khetragyam chapi manavidhi. Khetragyam means head body is khetra. And the living entity is the occupier of this body. So Krishna says, there is another occupier, interested person of this body. Khetragyam chapi manavidhi. That is myself. Khetrangam chapi manavidhi sarva khetresu bhavat. So what is the distinction between these two persons? One is the occupier and the other is the owner. He says, so sarva khetresu bhavat. In all different bodies, I am the owner. The living entity, he is the occupier, just like a big landlord. He has got many houses. And in each house or each apartment, there are separate tenants. Similarly, everything belongs to God. Isamasa, idam sadvam. Everything belongs to God. Nothing belongs to us. But the same relationship, he is the owner. We are simply occupiers. So there are two persons interested in this body. One is the individual soul living entity, and the other is the super soul, God. He is also within this body. Where he is staying, Ishara Sarvabhutana Riddhese Arjuna Tishtati. God is living within the core of the heart, and the living entity, he is also living within this core of the heart. They are living just like two birds sitting on the branch of one tree. These are the Vedic statements. There are two birds sitting on the branch of the same tree. One bird is eating the fruit of the tree and the other bird simply witnessing. This is the Vedic statement. So, the eating bird, we are living entity. We are eating the fruit as we are working, and the result of our working we are enjoying. But God, the super soul, he is not interested in eating the fruit of the tree. He is self-satisfied. He is simply observing how you are working. Because we are working with this body, and God is situated in the same heart. The God is there, and with individual soul also there. So why he is there? Because he is friend. So he is Amsarabhutana. It is stated in the Vedas that two friendly birds, God is our actual friend while we are friends, Srihizam. He is simply trying to turn our face towards him. So long he does not do so, he is changing different body. And God is also going with him. He is so friendly. Just to advise him in due time that why you are changing from one body to another, one body to another. Why don't you come to me and live peacefully, blissful life? That is God's mission. Jada jada hi dharma sabhlani bhavati tadatmanam sajami hum. So, God is so great friend of ours. He's all right. Witness. And as I am desiring, God is giving us facility. All right. You want to enjoy like this? You take this body and enjoy. Actually, you are not enjoying. When we have no discrimination of food, we can eat anything and everything, like say the hogs and pigs. So, God said, all right, you take the body of a pig and hog, and you can eat even up to stews too. I give you the facility. That is, as we are desiring, so God is supplying a type of body for our enjoyment. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddhese urjuna tisrati brahmayam sarvabhutani jantrarurhani mayana. He orders material nature that this individual soul wants a certain type of body to enjoy like this. So give him. So material nature immediately makes ready a type of body. Janjama bhapi smaran loki tajantpandri. So at the time of death, as our desires, my mind is obsessed with certain type of desire, we immediately similar body is ready. Vrivana trena, by superior law, the living entity is entered into the womb of a particular mother, and he develops the particular body, then he comes out and enjoys the suffering. This is going on. Bhutta bhutta pragyati. So, God is witness. He is along with us always. Whatever we are desiring, whatever we are working, he is witness and he is giving the result. Therefore Krishna says, Hitragvan kapi manavidhi. I am also one of the occupants of this body. But what is the difference between you and me? You know simply about your body. I know everything of everyone is born. That is it. Ketangan sapi mani vidhi. Sarva khetri. God knows what are the desires and activities of a little ant, and he knows what are the desires and activities of Lord Brahma, the biggest of the biggest living entity within this universe, and the smallest everywhere. God, it is said, Ishara sarva bhutanam riddhesh arjuna tishtati. He is situated in everyone's heart. It does not mean that he lives in the Brahmin's heart and not in the ant's heart. Everyone's heart. A small insect, a pulitzer-like size. It has also the same anatomical, physiological structure of the body, and the same way jumping and enjoying, you might have seen. So there is no difference between the bodily construction. Everyone has got heart and everything, complete. But according to the desire and karma, we are getting different types of body. This is called material existence. So long we shall desire to enjoy this material world, God will give us facility to possess a similar body so that we can satisfy our desire. Therefore, he situated witness Anumanta Upadrasya. He overseer. And without his sanction, we cannot act. We cannot act. Therefore, his name is Anumanta. He gives sanction. All right, you want to do it? Do it. As that. But ultimately, Krishna has highlighted that in this way, we will never be happy. This constant change, repeated change of body, and different types of desire, if you continue, you will never be happy. Therefore, he advises, sarva dharman paritya mame kam saranam bhaj. You just surrender unto me, and just be engaged in my service, then you will be happy. So here it is said, Kshetragam cha api mang binti, sarva khetre subharata. Kshetra, kshetra, dvayam, jnanam. Jat jnanam, matam, mam. So this is jnan, knowledge. We must know what is this constitution of this body. Who is the occupier of the body? Who is the supreme occupier of this body? How they are acting? How the bodily changes are taking place, and how we are suffering in this, I say, purposefully suffering, because in the material world there is no enjoyment. It is illusion. It is only suffering. Dukkhalayam asasatam. This place is dukkhalayam, simply for suffering. And if you say, never mind, it is, I shall stay here and continue like this, then it is athasatam. That also will not be allowed. You cannot stay. You have to change the position. This is material condition of life. So, Krishna, jada jada hi dharma sabhyani bhavati bharata, he comes down to instruct us that this sort of life, materialistic way of life, will never make you happy. You take to Krishna consciousness, you surrender unto me, act according to my advice, then you will be happy. This is Krishna consciousness. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.